it, Tom. Need to rethink this.
Out of my way, Hunt.
Walker, we got a problem. There's a storm and we need to...
Enough talk. I'll see you in Paris.
Altitude, 25,000 feet.
You had a terrible choice to make. Recover the plutonium or save your team. You chose your team and now the world is at risk.
Simon, myself, and Vin. That is the core Mission Impossible team.
The team is reunited, but also new elements have been reintroduced, which create a much bigger threat that they've never faced before.
I don't trust anybody outside of this room.
This is the CIA's mission.
You use a scalpel. I prefer a hammer.
Henry Cavill is something of a wild card.
The way the IMF and the way Hunt looks at him is like he's the enemy because he's being forced upon the team.
He's not just some observer. He's an assassin.
That's the job.
McHugh and Tom have put together a symphony of actors.
Rebecca Ferguson's returning, so I like the fact that Ilsa is a match for Ethan.
The journey that Ethan Hunt and his team go through, and there's huge stakes.
Which way, Benji?
Turn left!
Go, 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 go!
What are you waiting for?
I'm jumping out a window! Oh, sorry. Good luck.
Hi there. So did you like Tom Cruise in that video? Are you a Cruise fan? Well, did you know that he was only 19 when he started his career with the movie Endless Love in 1981, but only had a small part in it? He started gaining recognition when he acted in the movies All the Right Moves and Risky Business. Top Gun in 1986 was an icing on the cake that kick-started his career. Cruise is the first ever actor to have been cast in 5 movies back-to-back that crossed over $100 million. And if that isn't enough, Japan celebrates October 10th as Tom Cruise Appreciation Day. Did you notice any behind-the-scenes action? Stuntmen and women have been around for a long time, stepping in for various scenes. Now, the first Hollywood stuntman was ex-US cavalryman Frank Hanaway, who was cast in The Great Train Robbery from 1903 for his ability to fall off a horse without hurting himself. The first Hollywood stuntwoman was Helen Gibson, who doubled for Helen Holmes in the first 26 episodes of The Hazards of Helen from 1914. She was trained as a trick rider and married to cowboy star Hoot Gibson. Well, stay with me as I have a bonus, if somewhat controversial, behind-the-scenes movie fact for you. D.W. Griffith, a pioneering Hollywood film director, is credited with using the first close-up, the long shot, the fade-out, and other film techniques in his 1915 groundbreaking and highly racist film, The Birth of a Nation, aka The Klansman, a film that portrayed the Ku Klux Klan in a positive way. What's your favorite all-time movie? Let me know in the comments below. And remember, we publish new videos every day, so be sure to subscribe for more great content. See you next time.